back. I'm so pleased to have Mike Papantonio back with us, the attorney, America's attorney, host of Ring of Fire Radio, author of the new legal thriller Law and Vengeance. And this is the second of these extraordinary novels that Mike Papantonio has written. TROfire.com is the website, as in the Ring of Fire, TRO Fire. You can tweet him at Ring of Fire Radio or at Levin Papantonio. Mike, welcome back to the program.
How are you?
I'm great, and it's been way too long since we've talked. I'm glad to reconnect with you and look forward to having you on more often. Tell us about your new book and how the story in it relates to what's actually happening in the world right now.
Yeah, well, there is a series of four books. This is the second in a series of four. And what the book is about is actual cases that I've handled. This particular case it centers around the idea of a whistleblower case. And in that whistleblower case, what was happening was the government was making a product that was literally killing people. And unfortunately, the government, they were buying a product that was killing people, and the manufacturer of the product didn't disclose why it was killing people, but it was a gun sight that was so defective that it was off about anywhere between 2 and 3 degrees off for every 100 yards, which of course made the gun almost useless. So that's the first part of the story, and then the second part of the story deals with the C8 disaster that took place in the Ohio River Valley, where you had DuPont pumping just millions of gallons of C8 toxin into the drinking water of people, causing cancer all up and down the Ohio River Valley. Both of those cases are cases, of course, that corporate media didn't talk about, because unfortunately DuPont's a big advertiser for them, and as you know, the weapons manufacturers are big advertisers for corporate media. So what we do is I've just reduced a lot of these stories to thrillers. Although they're true, they're dressed up a little bit in the tone, and you create a thrill. The third book that I'm working on, it has to do with the opioid crisis that we're helping head up nationally, and it's called Law and Addiction. And then the fourth book is a book called Law and Terror, dealing with the international banks that are washing money for terrorists all over the world. So
they're all
based on real cases that we handle. They're dressed up, made into fiction thrillers, but they're stories that you ordinarily would not hear because corporate media doesn't tell these kind of stories. Advertisers simply don't allow them to do that.
You are on a roll, my friend. That's amazing, and your writing is so good. It's just remarkable books. I'm curious, as America's attorney, as America's lawyer, your thoughts on the rush by McConnell and the Trump administration to place, in fact, I guess they have some very specific criteria. You must be under 50. Between 30 and 40 is preferred. You must be a conservative crank. You must never have said anything bad about the president. You must, you know, whatever. I mean, these judicial appointments that the Trump administration is doing, and the last several years, the Obama administration, when McConnell was basically blocking them to the point that John Roberts wrote a letter to Mitch McConnell saying, you know, you're creating a crisis. This was during the Obama presidency. You're creating a crisis in the judicial bench. And then, of course, the whole year that they kept Merrick Garland away from the Supreme Court. What the hell's going on with our courts, Mike?
Well, what's happened is you have the Federalist Society now is in charge of who gets a chance to even sit in those chairs. And as you can see, the Federalist Society is sending us complete just knuckleheads. I mean, you saw the video, of course, with the judge who didn't know what a motion in limine is, had no idea with very, very basic issues like Daubert. He had no idea what was even being asked of him. You have judges who have never argued in front of a jury at all, have never argued in front of a judge at all, have never argued a motion at all. This is the equivalent, Tom, of going on the street and picking out some knucklehead and saying, how would you like to be an appellate federal court? And so what this really does, it does such damage to the Federalist Society. The Federalist Society at one point was able to say that, you know, we have some real purity about us, and that is we're strict constructionists, and we simply want the Constitution followed. And now we find out really all they are is this buffoon organization who has a political agenda, and the way to end that political agenda is to get more buffoons put in the court. I got to tell you something. We'd like to think that that wasn't much different under the Obama administration, but you're talking to somebody who appears in front of federal judges quite often, and what we got with the Obama administration was a little different. They were simply white shoe, silk stocking defense corporate lawyers who had never done anything for consumers at all, and you had Obama populating the court with that. Now we're populated with utter, complete buffoons. And so at a trial level, you can understand how disastrous that is when you're arguing to a judge and they don't even understand what the rules of evidence are. That's it's pretty impractical.
Is the I've read about the Federalist Society over the years, and my recollection is that it emerged in the 60s or 70s. If it was in the 70s, it might have been in response to the Powell memo of 1971, and that it kind of came out of the same ecosystem that the John Birch Society did. Only the respectable dimension of it, and that it has, in the last decade or so, become kind of one of the toys of the Koch network. Am I
right
misinterpreting what I've been reading? Or
no,
is...
No. The Federalist Society was based on a lie. It's nothing but a myth, and the myth is that these are people who want to have strict construction in the way that we look at the Constitution, that there should be nothing done creatively in the courts as we evolve as a society. We should still go back to the document and only look at the four corners of the document, the Constitution. But that was even a lie. What the lie is what the truth is, that this is a society that they're no different from the political hacks that surround the Koch brothers and have always surrounded the Koch brothers. They're nothing but political thugs who want a political system that inures a huge benefit to the haves and basically tramples on the rights of the have-nots. That's what the Federalist Society is. You can dress them up, you know, they have this aura of, you know, this aura of importance, but they are not important. If you ask most lawyers how much you really gain from anything that the Federalist Society puts out, it's almost nothing, because as you read their stuff now, you understand they're nothing more than political hacks. And we're seeing it firsthand now with these appointments that they're recommending that Trump engage with. And so I think it's great, because now we do see that they are a complete, utter fraud, and they have nothing to do with anything high-minded at all.
Yeah. We're talking with Mike Papantonio, America's lawyer. Pap, in the minute we have left before we hit a hard break here, what can Americans do about this obscenity?
Well, you know, unfortunately, right now, there's nothing they're going to be able to do. Look, here's what the Republicans want to pack the court with six. They have the right at this point, they have the ability to put 650 new federal court appointments in, from trial level, appellate level, all the way up the route. They have the ability to do 650, and that's what they've done. Trump is doing what Obama failed to do. Obama had a window. He had about a two-year window where he could have done the same thing and given us real quality judges instead of the corporate hacks that he appointed. But so Trump learned from that. And so now Trump is using this time that he has to pack the courts, and it's going to be irreversible. When you pack 650 relatively young judges in that position, you can't reverse it. We're talking about an entire generation that's going to be affected by a complete baboon kind of a judiciary.
Amazing. Mike Papantonio, America's lawyer. His new book, Law and Vengeance, a legal thriller based on a true story, or a series of true stories. Mike, Pap, thanks so much for being with us today.
Thank you.
Great talking to you. And check out Pap's book, Law and Vengeance, is his second. Check out his first book, too. We'll be right back.